There is an aircraft carrier off the west coast of Arcady Island. Your mid-weather is stormy. Approach the carrier from the direction indicated by the arrow on your radar. Intense wind and rain will reduce visibility greatly. Fly low. Turbulence and thunderclouds make a high-altitude approach nearly impossible. High waves and strong wind will cause the carrier to pitch and roll violently. Adjust your altitude and speed as you approach. Here is how to land on the carrier. The carrier is 1,083 feet long. That's roughly one-third the size of a normal landing strip. The carrier is equipped with arresting wires. To land, hook these wires. They will bring you to a stop before you run out of deck. After you spot the carrier, fly by once to confirm its position. Align yourself with the runway and approach from the rear. Drop your airspeed to around 54 knots and begin your descent. During your descent, lower your landing gear. Come into the carrier 10 feet above the deck. Bring the aircraft down as soon as you reach the deck. The arresting wires will engage your aircraft's hook and bring you to a stop. If you come in at the wrong angle or altitude, the arresting wires will not engage and stop you. If this happens, you will see "miss" displayed on the screen, and you will have to take off again without stopping. If the arresting wires do engage, you must quickly cut the throttle and apply the air brakes to complete the landing. Upon completion of this mission, you will receive a set of pontoons for your aircraft. your mission. Fly from Arcady Island to Corinth Island. You are low on fuel and will have to dock with an air tanker for mid-air refueling. The weather is clear, but you may encounter fog and strong winds. Take off and head south by southeast. The air tanker is flying west at an altitude of approximately 980. The air tanker is expecting to rendezvous with you over a group of rocky islands between Arcady Island and Corinth Island. Follow the arrow on your radar to the rendezvous point. Beware of air pockets and winds over the ocean and fog surrounding the rendezvous point. High winds are causing rock slides in the island chain below. Here is how to refuel. Approach the air tanker from behind and close in at a safe speed. Once you are close, cut the throttle and fly under the air tanker. After the refueling plane extends the docking mechanism, fly directly into it and dock. If you are moving too fast, you will be unable to dock and will damage your aircraft. If you dock successfully, a boom will automatically connect with your aircraft, and refueling will begin. When enough fuel has been added, the refueling will stop. The docking mechanism will then automatically retract, but your aircraft will still be attached to the air tanker via the boom. Your aircraft will separate from the boom and begin to drop. Open the throttle and point the nose down to increase speed and regain control. Even after refueling, your fuel supply will be limited. Follow the arrow on your radar, and you will see a remote island. This is your landing area. Land your aircraft here to complete the mission.
Thank you. Thank you.
Your mission is to land at the ruins located in the large underground cave to the north and recover a piece of the lost map. Weather is clear. Fly north until you reach an area dotted with lakes. The entrance to the cave is located here. The entrance is on the shore of a lake and is impossible to spot from a high altitude. Fly low to find it. The cave is narrow and filled with stalactites and limestone columns. Stay sharp. The ruins should be somewhere near the middle of the cave. Find the ruins and land. There will be a piece of the lost map there for you. After recovering the piece of the lost map, take off and fly north out of the cave to the shore. Fly northeast along the shore, and eventually you will see the landing area. Land here to complete your mission.